Norwegian boy band A1 are making plans for a return to the limelight. After a 10-year hiatus, they're about to stage the mother of all comebacks.
We are A1, and guess we're famous for being A1.
A1, the ninth most successful boy band in UK chart history, became A-1 when Paul Morazzi left in 2002. Mark, Ben and Christian went on to pursue surprisingly short-lived solo careers before deciding to reform 2 years ago in the hope of reliving A1's former glories.
I think they'll probably remember us as a band that aren't around anymore, really. You know, the hope is to do what we've done, you know, elsewhere, back in the UK, and grow the fan base, you know, so that's the sort of plan.
The Anglo-Nordic hunks amassed a sizable following of superfans during their heyday, and that seems to have rubbed off on keyboard player Mark, who's something of a superfan himself.
Mark is, well, you're into toys, aren't you?
Toys?
No, memorabilia.
Yeah, thank you.
Memorabilia. And toys.
Models. No, not toys.
Models. Not models as in, like, you know, take a picture models. Christian's into models. You're into models
well,
as in, like...
I'm not against models, I don't mind models.
No, but you prefer a model. If you had a model, sexy model for a model, you'd take the model.
Yeah.
So, I mean, you're all Benjamin, for example. I mean, it's seen a lot of models, isn't it?
His bandmates might take the mickey, but Mark is proud to be a super fan of all things geeky. And at his parents' house in Kingston, he's got over £100,000 worth of memorabilia to prove it.
Anything you can collect, I'll collect. It's ridiculous. Well, okay, I drew the line at Star Trek. That's a bit too geeky, I think. I'm a geek, but I'm not that bad. People probably imagine that I run around the house dressed up as Darth Vader with my lightsabers, but I don't.
The force will have to be with A1 if they're to pull off a successful comeback gig a full 10 years after they last played on British soil.
Nothing without you.
In Spain, Shane Lynch is enjoying the spoils of his UK comeback gig. And despite not having a number one here for over a decade, a sellout crowd of 600 loyal fans have turned up to welcome the boys back to the big time. The enormity of the situation hasn't been lost on the band's Norwegian manager, Christian Dyrison.
This is a big day for A1. We've waited for 2 years to happen. It's a big comeback, the UK comeback for A1. Or at least the beginning of the comeback. But we need to prove tonight that A1 is back for sure. So I'm really excited.
Just around the corner, thanks to the social networking power of the internet, loyal A1 superfans from across Europe have descended on an unsuspecting restaurant for a pre-concert fancy dress dinner.
Hello! One, two, three,
A1! My music has happened to a lot of people, and I also got the logo to the Maris. To all the bangers, my rubber things get to all the smiles. And posters, and I'd have all their albums. I always used to get told to shut up because I had their music on so loud, and I'd always used to be singing around because, like, I'm a singer, and they've been such an inspiration for me for singing. To be honest, they are nationwide talent, is, you know. Some people, you know, like, you'll go up to people and you say, oh, I'm going to go see A1, and like, who's them? You know, but that's only people that, you know, have never really got into music. But I tell you what, they are so talented, it's, you know, it's unreal.
See?
Meanwhile, with the crucial gig fast approaching, manager Christian heads into the bowels of the arena to G up his troops.
Yeah, I'm not nervous, and that's why I need to become nervous. So I will probably go in and I'll make him nervous. Let's see if I can just do experiment. Let's see if that works.
Are you Mark from A1?
Thank you. I'm here to make you nervous. Are you nervous?
I only get nervous 10 minutes before I go on stage.
Okay.
And then I get really nervous.
I'm not nervous either.
Are you?
The band might not be nervous, but the same can't be said for their superfans.
I'm excited. I'm nervous. I'm excited. Oh!
The most successful British-Norwegian band in history are performing a special unplugged sound check prior to tonight's main gig.
Should we just do the gig now?
Yeah,
yeah.
Okay.
This is the first time A1's die-hard devotees have seen their idols perform in nearly 10 years. And for some, like Maureen, it's all a bit much. After the unplugged session, the superfans have a chance to meet the band.
I have a breast on my left, right shoulder.
And Maureen is all nerves. She may not have got A1 to phone her nan, but Maureen's on cloud nine. In Cambridge, superfan Alison English, their comeback UK gig is a success. Backstage, the boys are geeing themselves up for the most important gig of their careers.
Don't be shit.
Are off to a good start, and their ice-cool Norwegian manager has started to melt.
I have cried twice, because back for sure, and this is what we've been waiting for 2 years, and they are amazing, and the crowd is amazing, and I'm just in love with everybody right now.
The gig's been a great success, and the good news doesn't end there.
Amazing news for you.
Amazing news.
Amazing news.
Heartwarming news.
Amazing news.
We have sold 14 t-shirts!
Yay! That is good.
And it's not just the band who have had a good night.
The concert, wow, what a fabulous evening. I really enjoyed it. I tell you what, it's definitely worth the wait.
Yeah. And if the fans' reactions are anything to go by, A1's attempt to reconquer the UK is up and running.
This is not the end. It's not even the beginning of the end. It might, however, be the end of the beginning.